The Philippine Navy calls a recent ramming of Coast Guard ships by Chinese Coast Guard vessels in Escoda Shoal a new challenge for the armed forces. Rear Admiral Roy Vincent Trinidad, Navy spokesperson for the West Philippine Sea, says the area where the incident occurred should not be seen as a flashpoint in the West Philippine Sea.
Bago lang naman nangyari yung girian na yun ng dalawang barko ng Coast Guard natin at ng Chinese Coast Guard. When we say a flashpoint, ito yung matagal na. Number two, the potential for escalation is great. Ito ay kasama sa mga panibagong dynamics, panibagong challenges na hinaharap natin ng Philippine Navy at ng AFP when it comes to the West Philippine Sea.
Meantime, National Security Advisor Eduardo Año reiterates Manila's unassailable rights in the West Philippine Sea. Now, this comes as Año exchanged information on the current maritime security situation in the region with his U.S. counterpart, Jake Sullivan. In that meeting, Año acknowledged Washington's ironclad commitment to their alliance. The siphoning of oil from the sunken MTKR Terra Nova in Manila Bay now in full blast. Let's get an update from our correspondent, Michael Deliso. Michael?
Hi, Ron. Good afternoon. The Philippine Coast Guard said the extraction of 1.4 million liters of industrial oil from the sunken empty Terra Nova in Manila Bay is expected to be completed in 2 weeks, with full-scale siphoning starting this week. Lieutenant Commander Michael Janencina, commander of Coast Guard Station Bataan, said about 200,000 liters of oil are expected to be siphoned out from the motor tanker daily following the installation of two booster pumps on Tuesday. According to estimates by the contracted Salvor Harbor Star, arrived from Singapore over the weekend, the booster pumps were able to increase the siphoning of oil from 200 liters per hour to 9,000 liters per hour.
We are expecting that this activity will flourish at the same time. Tuloy-tuloy po yung kanilang ginagawa. Katulong po natin sila nagbabantay at nagkakandak ng containment dito po sa motor tanker Terra Nova.
The afloat and salvage operations for the sunken ship will follow after the siphoning. Meantime, Encina said the oil sheen at ground zero has been seen covering an area of less than 500 meters and there have been only minimal oil leaks of less than 1 liter per hour. Back to you, Ron.
Michael Deliso with that story. Thanks. The fog from Taal Volcano has led to the suspension of in-person classes in some regions. According to the Education Department, over 2,000 schools are already affected. Our correspondent, Ara Perez, joins us on the line for more on that. Ara?
Ron, a total of 2,685 schools in Region 4A have suspended in-person classes due to the volcanic smog or fog from Taal Volcano. Based on data from the DepEd, as of 11 a.m. of August 21, this affected 2.8 million learners and over 89,000 school personnel. According to the Education Department, the date of resumption of in-person classes in the affected schools has yet to be announced. Meantime, 28 schools in Region 4B also suspended in-person classes due to the fog, while 254 NCR schools suspended in-person classes due to the pollutant-induced haze in the region. In-person classes in the said NCR schools have resumed on August 20 and on August 21 in the said Region 4B schools. Schools that suspended in-person classes may shift to alternative delivery mode, which includes the use of learning modules and online classes. On.
Thanks for that, Ara Perez.
P-pop superstars Beanie cap off their successful Canada tour with an electric performance in Ontario. Champ de Lunas takes us there.
The trip to Tribute Community Center from Toronto took 2 hours on August 18 due to rain and traffic. But fans of Beanie were unfazed to go to the last stop of the hit Philippine girl group's concert series in Canada. Blooms lined up so they can immediately enter once the gates opened. There was face painting and free braiding outside of the venue to give fans the full experience of the much-awaited concert. Like the shows in Vancouver, Edmonton, and Winnipeg, the fourth and final show was sold out at max allowed venue capacity, so much so that it had to be transferred to Oshawa to accommodate more fans. Hannah, a certified Bloom, thoroughly prepared for the chance to watch her idols.
Pinag-isipan namin yung outfit, hair, and everything. Tapos, Ayun, very excited. Nag-memorize ng mga songs, dance steps.
The jersey worn by Martina was eye-catching and one can immediately tell who her favorite is.
Kasi po yung mga kapatid ko, sobrang idol po yung sila Pinito. Si Malay, tsaka po si Aya. Para lang po may iba, para wala kaming kaparehas pag nagpunta po dito.
The show started at 8 p.m. Fans' eyes were glued to the stage with screams and shrieks. Blooms also got their money's worth, as aside from the maximum effort, Beanie engaged with the crowd with their vibe and energy check. Some of the songs sang by Beanie were Lagi, Carrera, Sherry on Top, Salamin, and of course, they did not leave without an encore performance of their biggest hit, Pantropico. As an added bonus, they went down the stage to the delight of the crowd. Fatigue didn't seem to be a factor as they arrived in Toronto and rehearsed at the venue on the same day. Beanie member Maloy says the energy that Blooms brought to the concert was a huge thing for them.
Like, parang na-energize kami, and because of that, nabibigay namin yung mga excellent performances. And I think dahil sa paulit-ulit na namin siyang ginagawa, parang nandun na yung muscle memory, automatic na siya. Kahit tulog kami, magagawa namin siya. And siguro dahil nga magkakasama kami, so isa yun sa mga strength, sa mga pinangahawakan namin every time.
Beanie Stacy meanwhile heaved a sigh of relief now that finally, their Canada tour is complete.
Yun po, yan. That's what we feel right now. Woo! Kasi finally, tapos na yung series ng Beanieverse. Pero happy kami kasi successful yung naging Beanieverse namin. And sobrang natutuwa kami sa mga Blooms and of course sa management, sa Beanie and sa girls.
As for Beanie Mika, she has good news for their fans in Toronto.
Maybe we'll come back next year because we have some upcoming surprises, especially for next year, because this year we're trying to focus on more shoots. But next year, I don't want to spoil anything first, but definitely expect that we're gonna come back.
But the Beanieverse craze isn't done just yet. As the nation's girl group prepare next for the grand Beanieverse back home this November 16 and 17 at the Araneta Coliseum in Quezon City. Champ de Lunas, ABS-CBN News, Oshawa, Ontario.